My name is Rebiya Kadeer, and I am a Uyghur. I come from an area called East Turkestan, the Chinese call Xinjiang. I was once prominent in the community and the seventh richest person in the area. I had money and a good life and respect, but I gave all that up so I could try to bring democracy and hope to our people.
1993年，热比亚在毗邻山西巷清真寺的地方开始修建以自己的名字命名的热比亚大厦。为此，热比亚与山西巷清真寺签订了拆迁补偿协议。1995年，热比亚大厦建成之后。
山西巷清真寺却并没有见到热比亚承诺给他们的十个铺面。大厦你götürüp ekemedim.
I was released in 2005 and moved to the United States, and since then I've been campaigning for my people.
My name is Gene Sharp, and this is the work I do. We have never had any funding or support from the CIA. How do you maintain the initiative?
It's true that after the Guangdong incident, I called my people abroad, telling them to demonstrate.
China's authority accused me very wrongly. Actually, the Chinese authority itself, they are responsible for bringing people to the streets to do this demonstration.
What about the population? Are they people who are willing to take risks?
But they took to the streets peacefully. It was the Chinese who sent in the army as suppression.
Separatist forces led by Rebiya Kadeer plotted and masterminded the riots that killed over 150 and injured 1,000.
The idea that you are powerless is not true if you don't have these you don't have these guns.
Telling my people to took the streets to the demonstration, it's nothing wrong.
Xinjiang government spokesman Han Min said the separatist World Uyghur Congress led by Rebiya held a special meeting on July the 1st, planning to use a factory brawl between Uyghur and Han ethnic workers in Guangdong province to create chaos.
You need to learn the ability to think strategically, to think how to plan your actions in the future so they can have impact and counteract the repression of your opponents.
That's right.
You've gone to the international media to say that you did not organize this riot. You've gone to them and say that you have nothing to do with these latest riots on the street. But at the same time, in the same breath, you've also said that you've asked the Chinese to change their policies, and you've accused them of demonizing the Uyghurs. and of cultural genocide. So how is this not inciting people or encouraging people?
The group plotted to instigate unrest by sending messages via the internet, telephones and cell phones. The content of the messages encouraged Uyghurs to take action on July the 5th and 6th to support separatism and put pressure on the Chinese government.
Study and think and plan before you do anything, and learn how to plan strategically to make your action effective.
A lot of people have been injured in these riots and these protests. Have you asked people to stay off the streets to restore calm? You are an influential figure.
On July the 6th, Rebiya held an emergency meeting of the World Uyghur Congress to make plans to further stir up both domestic and overseas demonstrations. She also held a press conference to put out distorted information about the riot. On July the 7th, another leader of the Congress, Dr. Queen Issa, said the violence would expand to other Chinese cities.
The pictures we've seen are of Han Chinese injured, Uyghurs turning over cars, setting things on fire, women on the streets being attacked. How do you feel about that?
My people, World Uyghur Congress, as well as all people, they don't like aggression. I understand my people. My people are very peaceful. They came to the street for demonstration peacefully. It was a very peaceful demonstration. News media should look at the both sides. Look at this picture. In this picture, the deployed troops are so much. It's seven line of the troops. It's all the demonstration, not very peaceful just over there. And how it's possible, imagine how it's possible in that situation, in that all among the army, how those people could, how the Uyghurs could injure anyone.
Assalomu alaykum, hurmatli huzur ko'rishlar, yaxshimisizlar. 6-oyning 5-chi kuni Amerika prezidenti George W. Bush va xonimi Laura Bush dunyo Uyg'ur
Many in the world do not know of our suffering. The reason you hear more about Tibet in the media and not about my country is because of the Dalai Lama. He has lived outside of his country now for almost 50 years. We don't have that kind of representation, and now I'm trying to change that.
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the
Assalom, Sharq Turkistonlik qarindoshlar, yaxshimisizlar? Ekran oldida Aygul Obliq.